Ah, to be young again. We all know that 2008 was a record year for youth voter turnout. Young people were out and proud, and a whopping 66% of their vote went to President Obama, whose boyish good looks, fluent tech speak, and inspiring promises of hope and change charmed their skinny jeans and baggy pants off. But what now? 4 years later, and the president's got some gray on his temples, little less pep in his step, and the harsh realities of recession are setting in for voters of all ages. And there's a new kid on the block. Governor Romney's tapped Paul Ryan, the spry 42-year-old fiscal wonk, to be his running mate. And while he may not make a convincing rock star for young people, there are some who think he may be able to pull younger voters to the right this year. In fact, a new Zogby poll conducted post-Ryan has Romney cresting at 41% among 18 to 29-year-olds for the first time. So does the president still have the magic touch, or can the two least hip men in politics make a case for the youth vote? Let's bring in our guest, Connor Tuhill, editor-in-chief of Next Gen Journal. Connor, we all know young people reliably vote liberal, but the other reality is that they reliably don't vote. 51% of eligible 18 to 29-year-olds voted in 2008, up from 48% in 2004 and the low 40s in 1996. So turnout for voters, young voters this year is expected to be much lower than it was in 2008. So how do we convince young folks to get out there and participate in this great experiment called democracy?
Well, I think that's a great point. And actually, what's interesting about 2008, turnout was actually considered to be pretty decent. And at that time, we had a Gallup poll that came out about this time before the election, and 78% of registered young voters said they were definitely planning to vote in November. This time around, it's only 58%.
Right.
So I think we're seeing a lot of disengagement. We're seeing a lot of undecided young voters as well. And I think really what we need to see in terms of trying to combat that is both candidates trying to speak directly to our generation and really lay out their vision for what they're trying to do and also why it matters to us, because we're at a time when a lot of young people don't just not trust in a given candidate, but really have lost a lot of faith in the political process overall.
So, Connor, to that point, are there specific issues that you would urge Governor Romney and President Obama to focus on that young people like yourself are particularly engaged in?
Well, I think above all, it's always going to be the economy. You know, we're at a time when over 50% of recent college graduates are either underemployed or unemployed altogether. Student loan debt is also important. Education and the national debt always rank pretty highly in polling done by the great folks at the Harvard Institute of Politics. But I think above all, it's going to come back to jobs over and over again.
You know, John Zogby, in that poll that we talked about earlier, gave an interview in the Washington Examiner, Connor, and he was talking about Paul Ryan and this idea that maybe he can pull over some younger voters. He said, in addition to it, you know, his youthfulness and the fact that so many young voters are concerned about the economy, he said maybe it has to do with the fact that libertarianism is getting a boost from young voters. Do you see that as much as a factor?
Yeah, actually, I think maybe the least compelling factor to me is his age. I was on here about 9 months ago, and I remember hearing, well, Ron Paul, how do any young people like him? He's, you know, 70-some years old. I think, you know, age is ultimately not the most important factor. What happens with our generation is you have a lot of people who no longer think public service is a very honorable profession, who don't think that politicians really believe what they say, who think they're willing to change positions easily and not take any risks. And with someone like Paul Ryan, I think whatever you think of his policies, you can at least look at him and say, here's a guy who's trying to have a vision and execute it.